When you first launch CuteFTP, you will come across two tabs on the upper left-hand side. The first tab is labeled Local Drives, and what this tab does is that it allows you to navigate through your machine, through your computer, and find the files that you will be uploading to your remote FTP server. The second tab is the Site Manager. This tab allows you to organize and manage various FTP connections so that you can easily find and connect to these at a future time. First of all, let's take a look at organization. You can organize various FTP connections into folders by right-clicking on an empty spot and selecting New Folder, and give it a name such as My Websites. Let's say, for example, you're connecting to other websites such as a media website. We can right-click on an empty space again, select New Folder, and call it something like Media Sites. But notice how this created a folder inside of the My Websites folder. We don't want that, so what we're going to do is we're going to just drag and drop it onto the General FTP Sites folder. And now it has been moved one level out, and I have two folders parallel to each other. Alright, so let's go ahead and create one more folder, and we're going to right-click on this folder this time and select New Folder. That way the folder is automatically created outside of those other two folders and we don't have to drag and drop it out. Let's call this one Family and Friends. Now, let's take a look at how to actually create a connection. In this example, we're going to connect to a fictitious website called mydomain.com. And we're going to put it under the My Websites folder. So we're going to right-click on that folder, select New, FTP Site. For label, we don't have to worry too much about how we label it because there's no specific rules. This is strictly for your own reference. So feel free to use capital letters and spaces, whatever makes things easier for you. So in this case, I'm just going to call it My Website. For host address, this will differ depending on what server you're connecting to. Sometimes it will be something that looks like ftp.mydomain.com, sometimes it's just a domain name, and sometimes it might not even be a domain name. It might just be an IP address. So check with your web hosting provider or the person that is providing the FTP server for you for the actual connection address. In this case, the address to my fictitious FTP server is simply mydomain.com. For username, we will use my domain. Again, sometimes the username changes depending on how the username was created. Some usernames actually look like an email address now. The password I set up for this particular account is test123$. And you'll notice that you also have various tabs in this section. The type tab basically allows you to set up different protocol types. For example, whether it's an FTP connection or an SFTP or even an HTTP connection. If the server is using a port number other than 21, you might want to set that here as well. For the Actions tab, in some cases we might want to connect to a specific folder so that we don't have to navigate our way out of it. Since this connection is for our website, I know that because this is a Linux server, my website files are going to go into the public_HTML folder. So I'm typing that here. For the second field, where it says when the client connects, switch to this local folder. This actually controls what shows up under your local drives area, and it allows us to pre-configure a folder to use as the local website files on my machine. These are the files that I edit locally and upload to the server. In this case, I'm setting up a folder underneath the my documents folder labeled mydomain.com, and that's the folder that's going to contain all my website files that I will be uploading. All right. So once I've located the folder on my machine, I simply press OK. Then we press OK one more time to confirm the changes. And now we have a connection pre-configured. You can do this for as many servers as you want. Or even in this particular case, I can connect to the very same server in different ways. For example, let's go ahead and create one more connection. This time we'll use the connection wizard. The connection wizard is a guided way of setting up a connection so that in case you are new to the subject matter or just don't want to fiddle with a lot of the specific settings, you can just be guided through the process. So let's go ahead and click the next button. For host address, we're going to type mydomain.com. For site name, again, there's no rules to this. We can put spaces if we want. So I'm just going to add the word full to differentiate it from my previous connection. We click next, and then we type in our username and password. When we're ready to proceed, we click the next button. For default local folder, we're going to skip that for just a moment. And instead, let's talk about the default remote folder. In this connection, I want the client to connect to the root level of our FTP connection. That's going to be outside of the public underscore HTML folder. So I'm going to leave that blank. But for local folder, I'm going to select desktop. I'm going to click next and then finish. And as soon as we do that, the connection is made. As you can see, these are all my server folders, including my public underscore HTML folder. If we double click on the my website connection, a new connection is made on a new tab. And as you can see, this time we were connected directly into the public underscore HTML folder. And now we can begin uploading our files. Congratulations, you now know how to configure CuteFTP.